I had a tower moment. I don't know what you guys might call it, but a self-realization. Today is what happens when I stop listening to spirit and let's say if I don't put God first, I'm going to try to do something that's not really beneficial to me. It's easy to get sidetracked. It's an everyday hustle trying to stay in a center of doing the right thing. But what I love about this experience is that once you're one with spirit, it's like having a leash around your heart of protective security. Spirit will say like, hey, you know, you didn't ask my permission and you didn't talk to me about it. So, you know, you can go on and do that thing. And boom, a tower moment comes. It's like a self-reflection of what you need to handle inside of yourself that maybe you haven't seen or maybe you weren't conscious that it was holding you back. Now, my tower moment, I'm going to share it with you. My tower moment is accepting to receive. It's a lot harder than what people actually think. We're so used to give, give, give. But when it comes to receiving, I don't think there's a manual on that. I think you sort of have to trust the universe. And that's what I'm doing. My goal is to share knowledge and help people that have are in their co-creative abilities so we can all grow together. And when I started meditating and I basically found my oneness, I realized that there was a lot of baggage that I still needed to take care of emotionally. And then once you heal it emotionally, that's when the physical aspects tries to throw it out and just like, well, that's done. We don't need to do that anymore. But you need to feel it out. And it can get really uncomfortable. I know when my third eye opened, it was one of the most uncomfortable feelings I have ever been through. And that's truth. It was a part of me inside knew this is good. This is good. But the physical aspect of me, was holy shit, I don't know what I'm doing. I mean, have I dove into the occult so deep that a demon's going to come up and just basically take over and I'm done? No, that's not true at all. 444. That's not true at all. It's getting to know yourself. Basically to the most out there perceptions that you could possibly imagine. In order for you to let go of that and bring it back in. and accept it. Now, you know, other people can say what they want to say. But for me as a being, I know God personally. My best friend is spirit. Divine, Holy Spirit, all that. I respect the devil because he knows how to play a very good game. But I know my right from wrong. And when I'm wrong, I have to admit it to myself, or what's the point of growing, right? All I've been doing is trying to heal and work on myself. And I found out that so many people around me are so jealous of me glowing up, of taking my own reins. And it baffled my mind for so long until I realized what it was connected to. And therefore, that's why I have trouble receiving. Because I have trouble accepting still what others think of me. And that's what today's meditation brought on. So thank you, Spirit. Thank you, my Most High. Thank you, my ancestors. And this is what it means to be spiritually grateful. Because you're learning every day something new about yourself that you can express and share and possibly help someone else. So if you're having dark thoughts, you feel completely alone. This is where the mind sometimes tries to trick you into thinking that this is real. But it's not. It's just an experience, and it's temporary. And that's what spiritual strength gives you with time. Everything that comes at you is for a specific reason. A, to humble yourself. A, to be thankful. B, to be grateful. No matter what's going on. But sometimes even I forget at how much hate and resentment that I still have for the outside people that have done me wrong just because they knew what I was when I didn't know what I was. And manipulation, abuse, you name it. I mean, we're all coming from that same, you know, I don't have to explain it to you. It's the world we've been born into. And it's not our parents' fault. It's not our grandparents' fault. It's not our great-grandparents' fault. It's like a story where I heard, you know, at one point in time, a leader didn't know what a leader was because we had amnesia, right? And it's somebody that takes charge of a certain subject that he's really good at and brings both sides together. Sort of like the opposite of the Libra, where you see both extremities, but you decide to walk in the middle and mind your own business. A leader is seeing both extremities and finding a way to meld both so there is more peace, more gratefulness, and less chaos. I'm not telling you anything you don't know. I know this makes perfect sense. Being in a relationship with spirit, you don't know what's going to happen. That's the cool part. But the best security spirituality has given me, for instance, is not relying on someone else to make me happy. Which gets me back to that subject we were talking about in the past couple episodes about marriage and what I think about marriage. I don't know. I've never been married. Would I give up spirit and God for a relationship with a woman? No. So if that woman comes into my life and is not spiritual and doesn't know thyself, herself, I'm not gonna waste her time and I'm not gonna waste my time. The Lord works in mysterious ways. I don't know if this is going to resonate with everybody, but it's just, I'm not anything more special than you are. I just know myself enough to share the truth of what I am. And there's a lot of illusions out there, but the one thing I love about my life is that I can't fool myself anymore. And neither do I want to, because the less I fool myself, the better it is for everyone around me. Or that's what God tells me anyway. But all I know is if you're going through a hard time, do not, and I repeat, don't stay in your head. Share it. You'll be surprised at how many people will understand what you're going through. But a large part of the human society that we live in have been brainwashed, sort of like a chemical brainwash, to where we were told to shut in our emotions as men. We were told to not share our experiences. And there's a lot of people out there that were taught the wrong way on how to take charge of things. You take charge of things with the heart. It sure as hell isn't the mental. I'm grateful for that. Because I'm realizing real quick that all this work that I've been doing my whole life has gotten me a foundation that no matter what happens, I can still find my peace. I can still be happy, and no matter what's going on the outside, it doesn't matter. And I'm okay with that. Spirit just told me, tell him a truth bomb, tell him a truth bomb. Okay. Here's a truth bomb. Did you know that the richest people in the world, you know why they're going into outer space right now? It's because they can't stand the vibration. So that's why they're going to Mars. Because the planet's dead. Ooh! Anyway, all right. You guys have a wonderful night, and thank you for being here with me. If I can tell you one thing about myself is that no matter how scatterfucked the videos might be, there's always an important truth at the end of it. And it's going to be usually all love. So, with that said, I wish you guys a beautiful night. Namaste.